Good afternoon, and welcome to St. Edward on this Pentecost Sunday. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Good evening, everyone, and welcome as we celebrate life in the Spirit. I think it would be great if we didn't have all these masks on right now, that we would have that old high school cheer that maybe you remember throwing back and forth across the gymnasium at your opposing team. We've got spirit. Yes, we do. We've got spirit. How about you? But that might be a bit much with all of this cover-up going on. So I think it's important for us to realize that it isn't about whether we have the spirit or somebody else has the spirit. It's how cooperative are we with the Holy Spirit that is freely given to anyone. And it is that life in the Holy Spirit that we profess each time we gather as His holy people. So let us begin now as we call upon that healing Spirit, the Spirit of grace and mercy, of forgiveness, of reconciliation, and empowerment, that we may through this liturgy become evermore the servants of Christ.
Lord Jesus, you sit at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you satisfy our thirst for salvation. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you send us your Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your church may always remain that holy people, formed as one by the unity of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, which manifests to the world the sacrament of your holiness and unity, and leads it to the perfection of your charity. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the time for Pentecost was fulfilled, they were all in one place together. And suddenly, there came from the sky a noise like a strong driving wind, and it filled the entire house in which they were. Then there appeared to them tongues as of fire, which parted and came to rest on each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in different tongues as the Spirit enabled them to proclaim. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven staying in Jerusalem. At this sound, they gathered in a large crowd, but they were confused because each one of them heard them speaking in his own language. They were astounded, and in amazement they asked, "Are not all these people who are speaking Galileans? Then how does each of us hear them in his native language? We are Parthians, Medes, Elamites, inhabitants of Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus in Asia, Phrygia, and Pamphylia, Egypt and the districts of Libya near Cyrene, as well as travelers from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs. Yet we hear them speaking in our own languages of the mighty acts of God." The word of the Lord.
Send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, you are great indeed. How manifold are your works, O Lord. The earth is full of your creatures. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. If you take away their breath, they perish and return to their dust. When you send forth your Spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord be glad in his works. Pleasing to him be my theme. I will be glad in the Lord. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God who produces all of them in every one. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. As a body is one, though it has many parts, and all the parts of the body, though many, are one body, so also Christ. For in one Spirit we are all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we are all given to drink of one Spirit. The Word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked, where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed him his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." The Gospel of the Lord. Last weekend, we finally were able to come together through our state, city, and our church community as a family to give thanks to God for the many gifts that he has given us, and also to pray for those within our families, in our community, who have been affected by the coronavirus. How wonderful it is to see you all here and to be able to serve at Mass and to experience your participation. It is a very powerful moment. It gives me chills to hear and feel the responses that are shared. But we don't want to forget those who, for health reasons, age and anxiety, or whatever it may be, who are unable to join us in person. We are glad that you're able to celebrate with us through social media. You are missed more than ever. Our gospel this weekend finds the apostles just following the death of Jesus gathered together in an upper room. Jesus comes to them again and says to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit to go and make disciples of all the nations. Don't live in fear. I am with you always." He reassured them that they would not be alone and that the Holy Spirit would come upon them to guide them and help them on their journey. That was very evident in the first reading. The apostles were once again locked in because of fear. When the Spirit came upon them and gave them the courage to come out and proclaim the good news to all who gathered in Jerusalem that day to celebrate Pentecost, it makes me wonder what must have been going on through the minds of those who gathered there at that time. They witnessed the apostles busting out with great enthusiasm, probably all talking at once, sharing the news of the events that had happened. If we read the whole text, we would hear those gathered asking what this could mean. Others say they've had too much good wine. Peter, as always, had the answer. They aren't drunk. It's 9 o'clock. The apostles were speaking in their own language, but those with the difference were able to understand what was being said. This could have only have been possible through the power of the Holy Spirit that they had received. They began to preach the gospel in such a way that the Jews who gathered there were able to understand. And it was about 3,000 people were converted and baptized that day. In reflecting on the first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, I see a couple of parallels with what has been going on in our country due to the coronavirus and an inability to be able to attend Mass over the past few months. First, we can compare ourselves to the apostles who had been locked away, who locked themselves away from society because of fear of what could happen to them if they were out in the mainstream. We have been keeping ourselves isolated from our families and loved ones out of fear of contracting or passing on the virus. When Holy Spirit came upon the apostles, they were given the courage to come out of their shelter to spread the good news of Christ's life, death, and resurrection. We have been finally given the assurance and the courage to come out to hear and share in the good news as a community. We are also like the Jews who were amazed when they were able to hear the message while in Jerusalem of the mighty acts of God in their own language of the apostles. There is much joy in hearing this good news. This makes me think of our ability to reach so many during this time of isolation. Due to much work from those who took time to set up media feed through Facebook and other media sources, they put so much effort to make the Mass and Father Troy's messages available throughout this time. Even when there were barriers with the sound, they continued until it was perfect, and we thank them. As we heard, the Jews who were gathered in Jerusalem that day were from many different regions and spoke many different languages. Yet, they were able to understand the message in their own language. Throughout my life, I have experienced many different languages. With my time in the military, I was exposed to individuals who spoke different languages and dialects. How many of us have gone on trips to another country, and if it were not for an interpreter who would have helped with the language, it would have been very difficult to enjoy the country that we were visiting. The apostles, with many other followers of Jesus, just witnessed him ascend into heaven. Jesus had given them the instructions to go and make disciples of all nations. I am sure they were thinking, how in the world can we accomplish such a task with Jesus no longer around? The Spirit that was given to the apostles and those gathered together that day is the same Spirit that we received at our baptism. We were given the flame from the Easter candle. That is the same flame that came upon the apostles. Their interpreter was the Holy Spirit. And it will be there for us if we allow Christ to work through us. We are truly blessed with the technology that our world has come up with, which can help be used to help with language barrier. We can also take advantage of the technology to follow our Holy Father and the message that he has for us. How many times have we turned on the TV to watch a mass said by Pope Francis and open up the Twitter to read the tweets? For me to understand what is being said would be very difficult, but with the help of technology, we are able to hear or read his message and to understand it. It is almost like our apostles at that time at Pentecost were ahead of their times. I want to turn my attention to the flame of the Easter candle. It is a flame of hope, a flame of life. We are presented with this flame at our baptism, but it is also placed at the foot of a coffin during funeral mass. It symbolizes the light of Christ, which is the life that dispels the darkness of death. We are the children of Christ, of the light. The light is very present during the funeral vigil. We proclaim that death is not the end. We are being reborn all over again into the risen Christ. That same flame that was given to the apostles to go and baptize some of the people, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. As we gather today to remember and celebrate Pentecost, the light of Christ through the Holy Spirit coming upon the apostles. Pentecost is often called the birthday of the church. On our birthday, we come together with family and friends to celebrate that special day. This celebration often includes the lighting of candles, which symbolizes the number of years and that we have been blessed with another year. We often begin by lighting one candle for each year of life. Eventually, we may cheat and get the candles with the numbers on them, or let one candle represent a certain number of years. Especially in my case, with the number of candles lit, it could be seen from outer space. Look around our worship space. There are so many candles that are lit to remind us of the light of Christ. We also have the votive candles, which unfortunately are not able to be lit at this time, but they hold a significance. They may be lit as a form of intercession for a particular need, or in thanksgiving for prayers answered. They may be lit for a family member or friend that has passed away. They may be lit on their birthday or other events that celebrates the person's life. As we come together on this Sunday, let's wish our church that Christ gave us some 2,000 years ago a happy birthday. And let us be reminded, like the apostle, Jesus tells us, as the Father has sent me, so I send you. Receive the Holy Spirit. It is up to us to spread the good news to the far corners of the earth using whatever tools that we have available.
Let us stand now together and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became a man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With grateful expectation, we now lift up to the Lord these our needs and intentions.
For all entrusted with the Word of God, for preachers, presbyterates, pastors, deacons, and parents, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For believers everywhere who share Christ's good news in a variety of languages and culture, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, religious life, and lay ministry, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who struggle daily with the effects of the coronavirus, for healthcare workers, for the sick, for those isolated in nursing homes, in assisted living facilities, for businesses struggling to get back on their feet, for the class of 2020, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our communities. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our dearly departed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And today we especially remember Norb Hummel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. I mean, it's well, remember today, those who have been affected by the violence that we have seen in our city in the last couple of days. We pray today that a spirit of peace will reign in our hearts and in our lives and in our streets tonight. We pray that the cry of justice may be heard and may be sought and found through nonviolence. We pray to the Lord. And I don't know if the astronauts went off today or not, but then let's pray for all of them, and especially the men and women who are staring at screens right now and making sure that everything going on up there works for all involved in our space exploration and the NASA, for them and for the great quest that they seek in understanding the heavens. We pray to the Lord. Gracious and loving God, we pray in and through the power of your Holy Spirit, may it continue to direct our lives and help us to grow in holiness. For we make our prayer in and through that same Spirit, through Christ our Lord. Amen. My brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Pour out upon these gifts the blessing of your Spirit, we pray, O Lord, so that through them your church may be imbued with such love that the truth of your saving mystery may shine forth for the whole world, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For bringing your Paschal mystery to completion, you bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children by uniting them to your only begotten Son. This same Spirit, as the Church came to birth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God, and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy,
Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis our Pope and Joseph our Bishop and all the clergy, the religious, and your people everywhere, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Immaculate Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Edward the Confessor, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed now by divine teaching, we stand and dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Thank you. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace. Behold, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep me safe for life eternal. Amen. Let us pray. May these gifts we have consumed benefit us, O Lord, that we may always be aflame with the same Spirit whom you wondrously poured out upon your apostles, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our announcements for this evening. Once again, we will be dismissing by rows from church this evening, beginning with the back of church. So if you would wait until you have left the church proper and to gather, and if you'd like to have conversation at a distance, please do that in the parking lot. We also have bulletins this evening, so you can pick those up on your way out of church this evening. If we need some help sanitizing the church after Mass, and we have some sign-ups, if you would like to do that for other Masses, that would be greatly appreciated. And also we have greeter schedules at the welcome table, those folks are going to be helping out with our sanitizing stations as you come in as well. As you probably know, due to the coronavirus, we're unable to have our parish picnic this year in June. After discussing this issue with the picnic committee, we developed a new plan. So here it is. We are still going to have a picnic. Okay. This is a Catholic church, and we are not dispensing with picnics or fish fries forever. That would be sacrilegious, I think. We've scheduled a one-day picnic for Friday, July the 24th, with inflatable activities for families. That will happen actually the night of Thursday, the 23rd. So our picnic is still a three-day weekend, but it has some different components. On the Thursday, we'll have some inflatables for the kids, some fun for the family. On the 24th, that Friday, we'll have a regular picnic evening. And on Saturday, the 25th of July, from 5 to 11, we will be having a concert that will be featuring the Thunderstruck and local bands. So, Alice, you live right across the fence. Honey, you might want to go away for the weekend, because you ain't getting no sleep until about midnight. I guarantee you, you will not get any sleep. So that'll be kind of an early going away for me. So if we get in trouble, I'm leaving. So it doesn't matter. You all do the cleanup, because I won't be here. On the 26th, that Sunday at 12:30, we will draw the 50-50 capital prize drawing live on Facebook. And for more information about our capital prize drawing, that will be coming out soon. Even if the picnic and the concert are canceled, we're still going to have that capital prize drawing. It will be done online, and the drawing will still happen on Sunday, July 26th. So please plan on joining us for this fun and exciting adventure if social distancing restrictions have been lifted. Pray for the success of this fundraiser and for the end to this virus. By participating in Capital Prize, you will be supporting our parish and our school. Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Please bow your head for a solemn blessing.
May God, the Father of lights, who was pleased to enlighten the minds of the disciples by the outpouring of the Spirit, the Paraclete, grant you gladness by his blessing, and make you always abound with the gifts of that same Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
May the wondrous flame that appeared above the disciples powerfully cleanse your hearts from every evil and pervade them with its purifying light.
Amen. Amen.
And may God, who has been pleased to unite many tongues in the profession of one faith, give you perseverance in that same faith, and by believing, may you journey from hope to clear vision. Amen.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.